In this video, we will learn about bitbutton components. Some Delphi programmers also refer to these as bitmap buttons because of the image or bitmap on their surface. I will demonstrate a few bitbuttons in this tutorial, but you must also practice this demonstration in your own instance of Delphi. In this tutorial, we will continue with this project that we started in Unit 6.1. Our project already has panels and a button on the form. In every individual tutorial in this lesson, we will learn about the features of one specific component or class, and we will add it and configure it for this graphical user interface. After we completed this tutorial, our graphical user interface will also have two bitbuttons inside the panel on the right side of the form. And after every video, your user interface will gradually evolve to look like this one. If the contact information project that you created in Unit 6.1 is not open, you must first open it in Delphi. So, go ahead to the folder that you created earlier and open the contact information application. Here, I already have it open. In this panel, I already added a regular button. It was done in the previous tutorial. In this video, we will also look at buttons, but this time we will explore a special type of button called the bit button or bitmap button. Click the tbutton class here in the additional tab of the tool palette. Click here inside the panel to drop a bitbutton instance in the panel. Select the tbitbutton class again and drop another instance under the first one. Repeat these steps again to place two more bitbuttons inside the panel, like this. In total, you must have four bitbuttons. In this tutorial, I will just demonstrate a few of the properties of bitbuttons. After watching this video, you can play with all the other properties to see what is available to you. These four bitbuttons are named bitbutton 1 to bitbutton 4. We will, however, change the names of all our components in a different exercise. It is a good practice to use descriptive names for our components. The four bitbuttons are also contained in a panel called panel 5. Here, we see all their names listed under panel 5. Now, select button 1. Scroll down in your object inspector until you find the kind property and click on it. Drop down the combo box next to kind. Here we see a list of all the different kinds of bitbuttons. I'm not going to use all these, but after this video you can explore them on your own. Select BK retry. The BK prefix is the convention used for bitbutton kind. Now go and have a look. There's a picture that displays on the button. Scroll up to the caption property and select it. Change the caption to reset. Notice that I've typed an ampersand as the first character of this caption. I typed it here in front of the R of the word reset. You must also type it like that. I will explain later in this video why we are doing that. Change the left property to 15 and scroll to the top property and make it 40. Now select button 2. Change its kind property to BK abort. Look at the bitmap displayed on the bitbutton now. Change the left property to 15 and scroll to the top property and make it 70. We will not use this button in our application. I'm only adding it for demonstration purposes. Now select button 3. Change its kind property to BK help. And look at the image of the question mark that is displayed on this bitbutton. Change the left property to 15 and scroll to the top property and make it 100. We will also not use this bitbutton. It's only to demonstrate the different varieties of bitbuttons. We will delete it in a moment. Now select bitbutton 4. Change its kind property to BK close. Look at the image displayed on this bitbutton. Change the left property to 15 and scroll to the top property and make it 415. We will definitely use this bitbutton. The nice thing about a bitbutton that has its kind property set to close is that you don't have to write code for it to close your form. It does it automatically because the code is already predefined or built in by the Delphi developers. Let me demonstrate that. Run your application. Now this looks nice. It's very colorful. Click on the reset bit button. Nothing happens because we need to write code for the bit buttons on click event to make it work. Click on the abort bit button. It's also not doing anything because it also needs code. The same with the help bit button. Nothing happens when I click it. Now click on the close bit button. And that will close your form. You didn't have to write a single line of code for the close bit button. Now, in the previous video, I demonstrated how you can select and change properties of more than one component at the same time. I mentioned that there are two ways to do it. I demonstrated the first way is to simply drag over the components that you want to select. The second way is to use the Shift key on your keyboard. First, select the abort bit button. Now, press the Shift key on your keyboard. While holding the Shift key down, select the help bit button. You can now release the Shift key. These two bit buttons are now selected. Notice the handles. You can also see that the Object Inspector indicates that two items are selected. In the Structure panel, you will also see the names of the two bit buttons highlighted. Now, select the Caption property in the Object Inspector and clear the caption. The captions are now gone. Okay, as promised, let's look at the reason I asked you to type an ampersand in front of the reset bit button's caption. First, select the close bit button. Go to the caption property. Here, you also see an ampersand in the front of the caption. When you type an ampersand for any component that has a caption, you are creating an access key for that component. An access key is similar to a keyboard shortcut key. It allows you to use keyboard keys to perform the clicks on your buttons, menus and bit buttons. It works like this. If we look at the caption of the reset bit button, the ampersand is in front of the R. That means the R is the access key. You will also see on the bit button that the R has an underscore. Let's look at the caption of the close bit button again. The ampersand is in front of the C. So C is our access key. On the close bit button, the C has an underscore. The first character doesn't always have to be the access key. I can, for example, change the caption of the close bit button so that the ampersand goes in front of the O. Now, the O is the access key for the close bit button. And the underscore now appears under the O on the bit button. Now let me demonstrate what all this actually means. Run the application. The reset bit button's access key is R. Press the Alt key on your keyboard and hold it down. While pressing the Alt key down, press R on your keyboard simultaneously. Nothing happens, but if we had code for the reset bit buttons on click event, that code would be executed now. But because we haven't written any code yet, the button has nothing to respond to when we use the access key. Remember, I demonstrated that the close bit button has its own built-in code that will close the form. So, if we use its access key, our keyboard should perform its on-click event. Let's try it. The access key for this close bit button is the O. Press the Alt key on your keyboard again and hold it in. While pressing the Alt key down, press the O key on your keyboard. And this will close your form. It is as if you have clicked on the close bit button. Now, let's make a few minor changes before we save the application. Go to the caption of the close bit button and change it so that the ampersand is in front of the C again. The C key will now be the access key in the future. Finally, select the abort bit button and press the Shift key. While holding the Shift key down, also select the help bit button. Both the abort and the help bit buttons are selected. Press the delete key on your keyboard. Now, also see how all these bit buttons stay within the panel when I move the panel. And this concludes the demonstration of the T-BitButton class. We will do a lot more work with bit buttons in the future. Also remember, we will continue with this project in the next video, so click the Save All button. I also want you to go and explore some of the other properties of bit buttons in your own time before watching the next video. In the next video, we will explore labels. I'll talk to you again in the next video.